Hi guys, welcome to WebSensePro, welcome to another Shopify how-to video. Just like all other videos, this video is also demanded by you guys. So I was getting a lot of comments, not a lot of comments, like 5-10 comments which I got, that how we can remove powered by Shopify. And I tried to teach them via comments that you can just go to add a default theme content and you can remove the powered by from there. But they were like, where do we need to click for that? Where do we need to change it? Can you please create and explain a video for that? So here is the video, where it's a pretty basic level video for the beginner level. If you don't know how to remove powered by from your Shopify theme, then this video is for you. Make sure to watch the complete video. And if you have not subscribed to this channel yet, please make sure to subscribe this channel. I keep creating videos related to WordPress, web design development, especially Shopify, in order to help you guys to improve your Shopify store and to improve the experience of your visitor coming to your store, which will help you get more sales to your store. Okay guys, so as you can see on my screen, I have this Shopify theme, which is Dawn theme. And if I scroll down to the bottom, I have this powered by showing up. Now I'm going to show you guys how you can remove that. And before that, I want to share some of the other tutorials which I have created. So here's the icon slider, which I have recently created. You will get the link in the description. If you want to add icon slider, the stylish icon slider like this, you can easily add it without using any app. Similarly, I have created a tutorial for frequently asked questions, and one of the most famous tutorial is adding a video with loop. So if you want to add a video on your homepage with the loop feature on, you can use that tutorial. Currently by default, Shopify does not have that feature. So if you add a video on your Shopify store, you'll have to manually click on that video to play that video again. But if you follow the tutorial which I created, you will be able to add the video which will be on loop. Okay, now let's go to the backend of Shopify store and try to remove the powered by, which is super simple. So I'm going to go to the backend of my store by navigating to /admin. I'm hoping you are already logged into your Shopify store. And from there, let's click on online store. And from there, you must be seeing these three small dots. Click on these three small dots and then click on edit default theme content. That's what I was saying on my comments, if you were the one who commented me out. So you will have to click on edit default theme content. Click on it. And from here, from this screen, simply search for powered by. Oops. So here you're seeing powered by Shopify already written. All you have to do is just click on it and add a space. That's it. Your powered by Shopify will be removed. So let's click on save. Now let's get back to our Shopify homepage. Hit refresh, scroll down to the bottom, and now you can see that we do not have any powered by Shopify on our Shopify store. You can add your own custom branding as well if you want to. So let's go back to here and add powered by WebSensePro and click save. And now when I go back to the homepage and hit refresh, it's going to show powered by WebSensePro. You can add your own company branding showing up here, powered by whatever your company name is, and it will show up here really easily. So that's it for the tutorial, guys. Let me know if you want to watch more tutorials related to Shopify. I'll definitely create more from your comment suggestions. Until next video, have a great day.